Grace and peace to you, my brothers and sisters of the Evangelical Presbyterian Church, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. If we haven't met yet, my name is Dean Weaver, and I am privileged to serve you as the stated clerk for our denomination. I bring you greetings today in this format in a way that perhaps is familiar to some of you. For a number of years, my predecessor and good friend, Jeff Jeremiah, brought you regular strategic updates through this medium in what was known as the Jeremiah Journal. Now, we don't have a name for this yet. So if you have a suggestion, Weaver Wanderings or Weaver Weavings or anything other better than that, we would love to hear from you. So please contact our Director of Communications and Digital Strategies, Brian Smith, because he and I would both be happy for your help on that. But we do think it's valuable every so often to come to you in this form to communicate some strategic things related to the life of our church and the life that we share together in following Jesus. I hope that you've had the opportunity to join us in our podcast, In All Things, which is a podcast that I host. We drop a new episode every Friday, and we started off by getting to know people in the office of the General Assembly and how God has wired them, called them, and is using them to serve our presbyteries and congregations. And they're really informative times. If you don't know much about the EPC or the General Assembly office, listen to those podcasts, and I think you'll be encouraged and blessed. Each one's about 30 minutes long, and you can listen to it as you're driving to work, as you're working out, or going for a walk. It's really, really easy, but I think you'll find them really informative. We're also starting to add EPC authors and other best practices that I think will be helpful, both in terms of church health, but also in terms of just our own spiritual formation in our life of following the Savior. So I hope that you'll tune in to In All Things, our podcast, and you can find that on epc.org. You can go to Spotify, Podbean, any one of the major podcast sources, and you'll find it there. Just search In All Things and spread the word, if you would. But from time to time, a video such as this that could be played at a session meeting, a presbytery, or just on your own computer to help you to kind of tune in to maybe what is current in the life of the EPC from a strategic vantage point. And I do that today because we've just concluded our January meeting of the National Leadership Team. If you didn't know, the NLT meets four times a year. The August and January meetings typically focus on strategic planning and strategic implementation. The October and April meetings typically are a little more business focused. So for example, in the upcoming April meeting, we'll be planning for the General Assembly. That's a heavy lift. And then we'll be doing our budget. So those are the kind of business things we'll do at the April meeting. But just coming out of our strategic time together in January, I'm excited to share with you the initiative and direction of our denomination as per its leadership. And I think you're going to find it exciting too. The EPC was founded a little over 41 years ago, and one of our distinctives, and it's right there in the beginning of our name, the Evangelical Presbyterian Church, one of our distinctives is actually evangelism. And so we're looking at doubling down on evangelism. And what does it mean to create an evangelistic culture in our presbyteries and in our congregations? And how can we help provide resources and facilitate our congregations becoming evangelistic, that every member would be able to be comfortable sharing the good news of Jesus with their friends, family, and coworkers? Of course, we're not trying to make anybody do anything, but the Evangelical Presbyterian Church exists because we have good news to share. And if there is one need that this world has above all else, it's the need for a Savior. And we have the calling to be able to share the good news of the answer to that need that they so desperately need to hear. The reality is most of us, we're intimidated or uncomfortable in sharing the gospel with others. And we have some ideas on how to help equip and empower people so that it would be much more conversational and something that they feel more confident in being able to do. And you'll hear more about that in the days that come. But I want you to know that we gave a lot of time to thinking about church planning, church health, world outreach, effective biblical leadership, those are our four strategic priorities, and how those four things actually all help us get at the Great Commission. You maybe heard it said by Pastor Rick Warren in his book, The Purpose-Driven Church, that a great commitment to the Great Commandment and the Great Commission makes a great church. The Great Commandment being loving God and neighbor, the Great Commission is making disciples to the ends of the earth. So if we want to love God and love neighbor, then we need to be able to take this good news of the Savior to our neighbors, both near and far. And we'll be doing that at this General Assembly coming up next summer at Ward Church in Michigan, the third week of June, as we always do. The theme coming up this year, appropriately, is Acts 1:8, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you to be my witnesses. I hope that you'll plan to come and join us for the General Assembly, and that you'll pray to the Lord of the harvest, as Jesus commanded us to send out workers into the harvest, because the fields are gleaning white. And the EPC exists for a time just such as this. So until the next time, my friends, let's each be committed to praying about how we can share the gospel with others. Grace and peace to you again, and may the Lord bless you.